Hi, I'm Jeff Decker, and yes, I'm in town. First of all, I want to let everyone know that this was the place where it all began for me, and I have so many people to thank for being here. And in this brand new facility, yes, it's our new studio right here at Waterford Mott. And this is the beginning. This is where it started. They often say that one's life comes full circle. Well, I don't believe that I've yet to come full circle. I am back. And yes, this is where much of my life really began and how it started off. Here's our new facility at Waterford Mart for Media Network. It's a beautiful place. I hope you get a chance to come by. And we're very excited to be here. So much of the things that my journey started off at happened in this building. My bands playing for the different dances, and where I ran for a student council president. I actually won the darn thing my first year here. And then they told me, well, first year student can't win student council president. It's a senior's thing, but we'll get into that. It taught me a lot about politics and how often those things work and how often they get taken away. Interesting stuff. We'll get into it. All of the sports, the endless hours in the weight room, working out, the hours and hours in the gym, and the practice sessions. And yes, well, this is where romance started, sure, in high school, and where heartbreak happened, and then hopefully, and did, heart started to heal and started off again. But this is where it started, and this is the place where it all began for me. Welcome back to Waterford and Waterford Mott. In entertainment news, when I sat down to write these commentaries for today, I was fortunate enough to be watching the TMC channel, Turner Classic Movies, and they were showing a Judy Garland bit where she's singing to the girl, and she's singing Have Yourself a Merry Little Christmas. And what a great song, and what a fabulous singer. But within that clip, they started showing her in some other movies, and I was seeing that there she was in another movie called The Good Old Summertime with Van Johnson. And I was thinking to myself, I remembered meeting Van Johnson. I was at the Birmingham Theater, and it was right after the play, and I got to meet him and actually talk with him for quite a while about movies and theater, and thought how fortunate I am to be able to have time with him and talk about these productions and snag an autograph. I started thinking about 6 degrees of bacon. That's right. There's a situation that they've created out in Hollywood. It's called 6 degrees of Kevin Bacon. And it's how every entertainment person can relate somehow within 6 different steps getting back to Kevin Bacon and or a production. And I thought how that might relate to myself. So I'm sitting there thinking of the 6 degrees and knowing how that actually worked. Well, funny enough, I'm thinking, well, I've now met Van Johnson, meeting him and shaking his hand and talking with him. And then seeing the clip with him, with the wonderful Judy Garland, and of course thinking about her in one of my favorite roles of all time, of course, Judy Garland in The Wizard of Oz. And then I thought how lucky to be just one separation I was, Van Johnson to Judy Garland. Pretty neat stuff. In another clip, from the actual movie In the Good Old Summertime, there's a picture with Van Johnson, Judy Garland, and they're holding hands. There's a little girl between them representing the idea of their child. That little girl happens to be Judy Garland's own daughter, Liza Minnelli. So now, I've shook the hand that held the hand of Judy Garland that held the hand of little Liza Minnelli. Kind of a neat, you know, the progression as the degrees go. I've had a fortunate time and a lot of very, very interesting adventures that I intend on this program sharing with you, because they were great times for me, but without having this basis and where I am right here at Waterford Mott, how it all started, and back with Media Network, of those degrees of separation, the Kevin Bacon degrees of separation. And that, just to let you know, I'm 1 degree off of Kevin Bacon. That's right. I did a commercial with Mickey Rourke years ago. Mickey Rourke was in the movie Diner with Kevin Bacon. So you can see how the degrees of, it's fun. In other news, we had a fabulous, fabulous parade in downtown Pontiac, celebrating Auburn Hills, Pontiac, Waterford, and White Lake. The parade was just a fabulous thing, and I'm so grateful. I've been hosting it for 20-plus-ish years. Wasn't too terribly cold and not too rainy. We want to thank everyone. The Grand Marshal this year was the one and only himself, L. Brooks Patterson, a good friend of my family for a very long time. Want to thank Brooks for stopping and being that Grand Marshal and having a good time. So much of what we do in this area for Pontiac, for Auburn Hills, for White Lake, it just comes from the heart. There were wonderful floats. The patrons were there. The great bands from all the different high schools in the area, Mott included. Kettering was there. Highland, there was a few different. It was very good. And of course, the big guy himself, Santa Claus, that's right, and Mrs. Claus. So I got to speak with them, stop by and talk to the reindeer because, you know, those guys are busy. The DIA mobile truck and the ice sculptures. Man, you got to see some of these. So make sure you tune in for our holiday extravaganza special. That's right here on your media networks, Channel 10 and Waterford, WTV10.org, everywhere else. For our weekly news, sports, entertainment, we're going to be doing a lot of great stuff. Right here, stay tuned. I hope to be part of it. Media Network, it's your channel, folks. That's right. Waterford Zone, WTV10.org, or Channel 10 right here in Waterford. You can see it anywhere in the whole universe. In sports, it's been a great season. How about a fabulous season for the Broncos of Western Michigan? Oh my God, not a single loss. They now take their talents January 2nd on to take on the Big Ten's own Wisconsin in the Cotton Bowl at Arlington Stadium, the home of the Dallas Cowboys themselves. Good luck, Bronx. You go get them. And I feel I need to say a word because between Jim Wellhelm and I and some other people, we're just sick of what's going on in the playoffs scenario for the championship in college football. You watched the University of Michigan Wolverines get ripped off, in my opinion, and many others. We see them lose to Ohio State. And yes, there were so many mistakes in this game by the officiating staff that it just has to be brought up. I feel, and many others, that something has to be done. In order to make it a true championship for college, let's add another game. That's right. That scenario just doesn't play out. You need to take and create something that can actually work. Make it the best 8 teams and then narrow it down from there. It's a revenue, folks. The colleges aren't going to matter. And these kids take that long break before the championship games, 4 weeks. They're ready to keep playing now. They're playing on a weekly basis. Don't stop that. Members of the Michigan Sports Broadcasters Association, such as myself, were then fortunate enough over the past couple weeks to be invited down to Joe Louis for what is Joe Louis's fond farewell. So if you haven't gone down to Joe Louis, make sure you make it down there to say your goodbyes for the place where we've won a couple of Stanley Cups and have so many great memories. Joe Louis, boy, it's quite the place. And not only did we know about everybody moving over to the Little Caesars Stadium for hockey, the new announcement, of course, is the loss of the Pistons at the Palace of Auburn Hills. They are also now moving down to the Little Caesars Arena. it's got to make you wonder what's going to happen to the Palace of Auburn Hills. Such a great place, so many fabulous concerts. I was a photographer for the Pistons for many years. And then just down the street from them, the Silver Dome. You've got the Palace, the Silver Dome in such close proximity. The Silver Dome sits there as what it was and its wonder. What a fabulous place the Silver Dome once was. Just gorgeous. It was a state-of-the-art stadium. People from Japan, around the world came to emulate the Silver Dome. And now look at the Silver Dome. Is that what's going to happen the next time for our own beloved palace? I hope and pray not. This is a very special time of the year. It's the holidays, right? And it's a great time to get together with family and friends, and I love being with my family. I've had a great loss this year. My father passed. And, of course, missing one's loved ones at this time of year is a very hard thing to go through. I love my father, I love my family very much. I know that all of their spirits live on. Remember that their spirits are with us always and that God's thinking of us all and his blessings are upon us and them. So many friends, so much family. This is the blessing that he gives us and that we have to give back to all of our friends and family. Make sure you do that over the holidays. Thanks, folks, for watching. I am Jeff Decker, and I'm in town. And